Would you rather fight a horse-sized duck or 100 duck-sized horses? Welcome to my first ever Q&A. The answer is definitely 100 duck-sized horses, because what are they going to do, like kick your ankles? That's no big deal. Imagine trying to fight a massive duck with that big old long neck, one bite and your head would just be gone. So definitely 100 duck-sized horses. I asked you guys on Instagram and on my community tab to submit me questions so I can answer them on camera so you can get to know me a little bit better. So my wife and I picked about 20 of the best questions, and now I'm gonna answer them. Let's just get right into one of the questions I get all the time. Why did you stop repairing consoles? For any of you that don't know, I did start a repair business where I took in people's consoles. People would mail them to me from all over the United States, and I would repair them and send them back, obviously for a fee. And I started this business about 5 or 6 years ago, and it went really well, and actually it went too well, and I just got super busy with repairs. About a year into that business, I started this YouTube channel, and the YouTube channel got views right away, but it didn't grow super big or anything, so it was no big deal. But eventually I started getting more and more views, and it took more and more time to make videos, and I started putting out a video pretty much every single week, and that started to take so much time. And I found that I really, really liked showing other people how to repair electronics. So for me, what it came down to was I couldn't do both. I couldn't run a repair business and a YouTube channel at the same time. One of them had to go, and so I made the hard decision to choose YouTube. Now the great news about that is I did have someone working for me at the time, a repair tech, and he decided to start his own business, so he takes all the repairs that I normally would have taken. If you go to my website, tronicsfix.com, you'll see that I refer all of my viewers who are looking for repairs to him. His website is shanefix.com if you are looking for repairs. When you are looking for broken items to bid on, how do you evaluate items before you bid, and what are the deal breakers for the items you fix? What profit margins are you trying to hit? First, I'll answer that last part. The profit margins, I'm not necessarily looking to hit any specific profit margins. I'm looking for a good deal and to make the most money possible. Now, I do it for YouTube right now, so when I look for items right now, I don't necessarily look for what can I make the most profit on. There are some videos I do where I'm looking for profit, but a lot of videos, I'm just looking for an interesting repair for the video. Now, back when I did buy them to make a profit, I'll give you an example of something that I would look for. If I was looking to buy a PS4, which I did fairly often because that's one of my specialties, I would look for something that powered on and went to the white light, and also had maybe a bad HDMI port, or the disk drive didn't work, or a bad hard drive, or something like that. That way I knew that it didn't have the blue light of death, as that's not easily fixable, in a lot of cases just not fixable at all. So that's just one example. Anytime I can get something that does power on but one of the other systems isn't working, that's usually a good sign. Now, something that's usually a deal breaker for me is if someone has already been in there trying to fix it. Not necessarily if the owner of the device has been in it, but if they've had a repair tech try and fix it, or if they sent it somewhere to have it repaired and the repair tech couldn't fix it. Usually if a repair tech's been in there and tried to fix it, it's usually either a really bad repair attempt, or it's just something that's just plain not fixable. So those are the kind of things that I would always try and avoid. That being said, there are some out there where a repair tech has looked at it and it's still something that's fixable. When I was running my repair business, I would get repairs in all the time from other businesses and other technicians who couldn't fix the device I was working on, and most of the time I was able to fix them. Do you have a significant other, and what do they think about your channel? Yes, I have a significant other. I am very happily married to my wife, and as far as what she thinks of my channel, let's just ask her. Please welcome Tronic's wife.
The channel. Well, I mean, it's okay. Also, I mean, Steve is really annoying. Actually, it's been interesting to watch the channel grow and change over the years, and more recently to be able to be a part of some of the behind the scenes things, helping with videos, helping come up with some of the ideas, things like that. That's been really fun. And of course, it's great that we get to work from home, especially now with all the craziness that's going on. Just being able to work from home and make enough money to support our family through YouTube and the other things that we're doing also, but that has been really great about having the channel. And then I feel like the channel is such a great place to have as a resource for people who are interested in repairs or just like to watch things being repaired. So that's been really fun too, to know that we're getting to help people who are interested in repair or trying to repair their own things or even get maybe start a repair business. It's fun to be part of that repair community, and I've enjoyed that even though I'm behind the scenes most of the time. That's been fun as well. So I really like the channel. I think it's fun. And now back to Steve.
Now on to the next question. Do you have children? Yes, I do have one son and he is around here somewhere. I don't know where he went, but yes, I have one. Another question I get asked all the time is, how did I learn how to repair consoles? The answer to that is pretty simple. I've always been a fixer ever since I was a kid. And to learn how to fix consoles, I simply bought broken consoles and started trying to fix them. When I first started buying PS4s, I had never even taken a PS4 apart before. In fact, they had just come out not very long before I started buying them. So to learn how to fix them, I just bought some and I started taking them apart, learning about them, seeing what all the problems might be, and seeing if I could learn how to fix them. I actually had hardly any soldering experience when I started fixing PS4s, so I was also learning how to solder at the same time I was learning how to fix PS4s. Also on a side note there, if you're looking to learn how to solder, I do have a free practical soldering for complete beginners course on my Game Console Repair School website. So if you want to learn how to do that, just go to gameconsolerepairschool.com. What's your favorite food? Also an easy question, my wife's lasagna is definitely my favorite, but if we're going out to eat, then my favorite is usually Thai food. I prefer things like yellow curry and pad see ew, and one of my new favorites is pad woon sen. Do you have legs? We've never seen them, so how do we know that you have them? Well, I can prove to you that I have at least one leg. And yes, I usually do film barefoot, and yes, I usually film wearing pants. How old are you, and do you prefer Android or iPhone, and what is your current smartphone that you use the most? I am currently 41, or 40, 40 or 41, I don't remember. Right now I use an iPhone 7 Plus. I will be upgrading that this year as the battery life on this is not great, and at some point I will fix it, but I do want to upgrade to a new phone for the new technology. I actually don't really prefer iPhone or Android as far as the device itself, but I do enjoy the ecosystem of Apple as I can use my phone and my watch integrates with my phone, and I also have a MacBook Pro that you probably watch me fix on camera. So all of those work together really well and it's just a really nice ecosystem. That being said, my editing computer is a PC and I also have a PC in here at my workstation and I also have another PC up in my repair office. So while my personal daily driver is an iPhone, most of the reason for that is just because that's the first smartphone that I bought was an iPhone. And since I was already in that ecosystem, I kind of just kept upgrading my iPhone. What did you do before YouTube? Well, before YouTube, I was a stay-at-home dad. While I was a stay-at-home dad with my son, we would go on all sorts of adventures, and I decided I also wanted to start making some side income. So I started finding broken stuff around the house and then eventually started buying broken stuff to see if I could fix it. And then that just built into a repair business, which turned into a YouTube channel, and now here I am. What inspired you to start fixing consoles? Fixing consoles is just kind of what I fell into, things I just found that I enjoyed when I was working on various different items. But as far as repair and why I still fix things and why I believe in repair, it's just a matter of there's so many broken items out there in the world and there's just not enough people out there fixing them. These days, manufacturers don't want you to fix their stuff. They want you to throw it away and buy something else so they can make more money. And I'm here to fight against that. I don't believe that's the right way to go. I believe if you have something that's broken, why not just fix it and keep using it versus just throwing it away and buying something else? Obviously, this planet has a huge trash problem, largely caused by humans just throwing stuff away and buying something new. While I can't can't say that I'm an extreme environmentalist or anything like that, I do believe that we do need to take better care of the planet that we have. Could you share what kind of soldering iron you use and where can I buy it? Sure, no problem. I have an FM203 made by Hakko. I also have an FM206 made by Hakko and an FR810B also made by Hakko. The FR810B is my hot air station, and then the other two soldering stations, one of them I have up in my other repair room, and then the FM203 I have down here, and I use that for when I'm doing soldering while I'm filming. I highly recommend Hakko products. That being said, there are a lot of other great brands out there, some cheaper, some more expensive, so just get what works for you. But I personally can recommend Hakko products, and I'll put links to all of my soldering stations down in the description if you would like to purchase one for yourself. What's the weirdest thing that you have found in game consoles? I would say the weirdest things are ants, moths, I'd like to say cockroaches, but that didn't turn out very weird because I saw way too many of those. And I found lots of things inside the game consoles, especially the disc slot. I've found money, coins, tokens, too many game discs, all of that standard stuff. What was one of the most difficult things you had to learn? Well, business-wise, one of the most difficult things I've had to learn is patience. I'm a guy with a lot of ideas, and when I see an idea that's not really working as well as I want it to right away, I'm ready to move on to the next idea. So over time, I've slowly learned to have patience with what I'm doing, and even if it's working not as fast as I want, if it's working, just keep going with it. And that's what I've done with this YouTube channel as well as my repair business. As far as repairs, probably the most difficult repair that I've had to do is reballing the APU on a PS4. Just because there's so much involved, you have to heat that chip and pull it off without pulling any of the pads, and then you have to clean all the solder balls off, put new solder balls on, line up the chip perfectly, and then heat it and melt everything correctly onto the board. I find reballing to be extremely difficult, especially with large chips and especially when you first start. What devices do you not want to touch, either for difficulty, part scarcity, or personal preference? I don't want to touch anything that has roaches in it, specifically PS4s, Xboxes, anything like that that has roaches, especially live roaches. That's disgusting and I hate it. That being said, some of the other things that I don't like are things like the Apple iPhones with iPhone locks, like iCloud locks on them. I find that to be a huge waste, and it's unfortunately why I do very few iPhone repairs, because you never know when you're looking at a used iPhone whether it's going to have any sort of lock on it, or even if it doesn't have a lock on it, it could be blacklisted. When you buy it, it may not be blacklisted, but then a month later it could be, so it's just so risky to buy stuff like that. I also find things like GoPros to be very difficult to repair, because GoPro also does not make their cameras, specifically the newer ones, friendly for repair. And so buying broken GoPros is just not really worth my time. That being said, I did buy some broken GoPros and I will be making a video about that in the future, so keep an eye on my channel. I got some GoPro Hero 7s and 8s. I don't think they're gonna be very fixable, but we'll see. So keep it on my channel if you want to see that. Are you a gamer? I definitely am not a gamer. Unfortunately, I spend so much time on my YouTube channel and repairs and just hanging out with my family. I just have very little time to game. I do play a few games here and there, especially if my son is into it. Things like Mario Kart, things like Zelda and stuff like that. But unfortunately, I just don't have enough time. Or I should say, I don't make enough time for gaming. I really enjoy building businesses, so that's what I put most of my time into. What are your favorite games of all time? That's a super easy question, and I think the undisputed best game of all time is Super Mario 3. Super Mario 3 was the first game that I ever really spent any time on when I was a kid. That all being said, as far as newer games, I would have to say Zelda Breath of the Wild is definitely my favorite newer game. What do you do in your free time? In my free time, I do a ton of just hanging out with my family. I do like hiking and things like running, but overall, I like to run my business and learn how to run it better and grow it and basically hang out with my family as much as I possibly can. What is something you've always wanted to learn how to fix that you haven't learned yet? High-end cameras, DSLRs, lenses, stuff like that. That's something I've done very, very little repairs on and something I'm planning to learn more about in the future. After which video that you released, do you feel like I could really make this into more than a side gig? That would have been back in the spring of 2019. Let me show you. Over here on the left of this graph, September 15, 2018, you can see my channel, it was doing fine, and then it started growing a little bit more at the end of 2018. And then 2019 came around, we had some huge spikes. These were the videos where I bought 8 broken Nintendo Switches to try and fix them, and those are the videos that sort of took off on my channel and really started bringing a lot of attention to my channel and really started making some more extra money on the channel. Now, as you've probably noticed, I've made a lot more videos where I'm buying a lot of broken items and trying to fix them on camera. They are fun for me to make, but also they really grow the channel. They do bring in a lot of income for me. And that's what's really made my channel take off and made it into a full-time income. That's gonna be it for me today. Thank you so much for watching this. I hope I didn't bore you too much. I hope you enjoyed meeting my family. I can't thank you enough for all the support that you've given me throughout the years by watching my videos on my channel and making comments. Leave any follow-up questions you have down in the comment section below, and I'll be hanging out in there for a while after this video goes live just to clarify anything or answer any more questions. Thank you again so much for watching, and I hope you have a good one.